Namaskar and welcome to the program. Every citizen needs to contribute to ensure a corruption-free society. The Central Vigilance Commission is the apex integrity institution of India and has the mandate to fight corruption. The Commission is organizing Vigilance Awareness Week beginning 30th of October 2017. And to discuss more about it, we're now joined by Mr. K.V. Chowdary, Central Vigilance Commissioner. Mr. Chowdary, a very warm welcome.
Namaskar.
Namaskar, sir. So, let me ask you about the theme first. My vision, corruption-free India. As regards integrity, where does our nation stand right now? And how do we accomplish this vision?
As per some international surveys, we do not enjoy such a high rank relatively, but we are not very sure about the criteria followed by these organizations in ranking various countries. Well, they are certainly, they claim they are honest and transparent, but nevertheless, all of us agree that there is a fair amount of corruption in the country. And it's not enough to recognize that there is a fair amount of corruption, and we all don't like that corruption to be there, and a lot of us criticize, a lot of us criticize others. But the commission, in its wisdom, it thinks that all this is not going to lead us very far. Criticizing by somebody, we are not going to change the system. The commission thought that we need to bring awareness in people that the corruption is not a good thing for the people themselves, the country, the society, the world at large. It affects us in multiple ways. It stunts development, it stunts growth. The sociologically also, the changes are very far-reaching for the bad. So we need to activate each and every person to think that corruption is not good for me, so I am going to stay away from corruption. And if there is any corrupt practice, I am going to bring it to the notice of the authorities who are to fight it. Now, by and large, the vigilance organizations are treated to be handling the people who have already done a mistake or done a misconduct, done a corrupt practice. So that goes on and on. But unfortunately, given the type of system we have, if the misconduct happens today, it may be detected after some months or some years. Then there is a long procedure. We are in a democratic country. The investigation takes place. Then you take the matter before a criminal court or a disciplinary proceedings departmentally, and it's a very time consuming process. Ultimately, the person is either convicted or acquitted. It is one part of the story. The second part is that how do you prevent those things from happening? So the Central Vigilance Commission, which has been set up in the present form under the Act of Parliament, under the Central Vigilance Commission Act 2003, it's a multi-member body. There's a Central Vigilance Commissioner and two Vigilance Commissioners, and we are entrusted with the task of ensuring good vigilance administration in all central government and central public sector undertakings and all autonomous bodies assisted by the central government, and also to supervise the work of the Central Bureau of Investigation insofar as the work relating to the investigations under Prevention of Corruption Act are concerned, and few other tasks. What we have been trying to do now is that identify which are those areas where there is a possibility of corruption, there is a possibility of nepotism, there is a possibility of some bhrashtachar coming in, and then try to rectify the existing systems or build a new system so that we prevent corruption from happening.
So, a couple of things that the viewers need to understand. One, not only talking about corruption, action has to be there and everybody needs to take a pledge. This morning when I told you that I have taken the integrity pledge, you shook my hands and congratulated me. So, how important is this integrity pledge?
As I said, first we talked about punitive vigilance. Somebody has already made a mistake, you try to punish him. Second, you devise systems, you put systems in place so that the crime or the corruption doesn't happen. The third is the bringing awareness in people that I should not be corrupt, I will not encourage corruption, I will not be a part of corruption. It is part of this third part of outreach activity of making people aware of the ill effects of corruption and making them resolve for themselves that they will not be part of the corrupt activity, that the commission has come out with this theme of integrity pledge. It is something coined by the Central Vigilance Commission. Those who go through it and believe that they believe in the values of this society, they believe in the values of this country, and they are for the good of this country, and they believe that it's not good to be part of the corrupt practices, etc., they take this pledge by subscribing some identity of theirs for the pledge.
So it is an important thing to rededicate yourself to the moral values.
The purpose is people ask, sir, what am I going to get by taking the pledge?
Yes.
Well, in material terms, you may not get anything. You will get a nicely printed certificate if you so wish. But internally, you have been an honest person and you wish to continue to be an honest person. This just reiterates and reaffirms your faith in the system, your faith in the values, your faith that corruption is not good for this country. And when people notice that people like you, people like me, people like others who have already taken the pledge, a movement is building so that those who are still undecided, those who are probably occasionally taking a little chances, or even those who have been regularly doing that, they will get some kind of a social and psychological pressure on themselves that they also reform and they become clean citizens.